Today we can study about foreign key constraint. We know the definition of foreign key. Foreign key is an attribute of a table which is the primary key of another table. It is an attribute of a table. The same thing is the primary key of another table. That means foreign key will relate two different tables. It link two different tables. In one table there is a foreign key. And in the another table, the same thing will be the primary key. So it will link two different tables. Using foreign key, we can link two different tables. See, you can see one example. So in this example, employee table and salary grade table are two different tables are there. Employee table and salary grade table. See, first go through the salary grade table. In salary grade table, S grade, salary and HRA. S grade means salary grade. S grade, salary and HRA. So this is the S grade is the primary key of this table. S grade is the primary key of the table salary grade. Understood? So I can say S grade is the primary key of this table. And when you come across this employee table, you can see E code, that means employee code or employee ID, name, designation, S grade. See that S grade is coming here. The same S grade is here. It is coming here also. So that means employee and SL grade are the two related table. And this primary key is there in this table, employee table. So primary key of the SL grade table will be there in the employee table. And DOJ, DOJ means date of joining. DOB means date of birth. So in this employee table, you can say E code as the primary key of the table employee. E code means employee code or employee ID. So every employee will get separate employee ID. So normally E code will be the primary key of that table. And you can see here S grade is there. The same S grade is the primary key of this table salary grade. So that means this S grade is the foreign key of the table, employee table. See the definition, it is an attribute of a table. Yes, S grade is an attribute of this table, which is the primary key of another table. The same S grade is the primary key of this table. See the definition and just try to understand the content. So S grade is the foreign key of this employee table and E code is the primary key of this employee table. Whereas S grade is the primary key in this sal grade table. So these are the two related table. Now in this case, this sal grade table is known as the parent table. It is known as the parent table and this employee table is known as the child table. The table in which the primary key is the foreign key set as the primary key. The table in which foreign key of one table is set as the primary key, then that table is known as the parent table. The table in which you can find out the foreign key, then that table is known as the child table. Understood? So wherever the foreign key is there, that particular table is known as the child table. That foreign key is the primary key of another table. That table is known as the parent table. Okay, so pair, when you create the table, first you have to create the parent table. After creating the table, you have to insert the value into the parent table. After that, you create your child table. One more example I'll show you. See two different tables you can see. In this table, stock dealer. See the dealer table. In the dealer table, you have D code is there and D name is there. D code is the, D code means dealer code. That is the primary key of that table. And go through the stock table. In stock table, you have item number, item name, D code, quantity, unit price and stock date. Where item number is the primary key of the table stock. The primary key of the table stock is item number. And you can see D code here. The same D code is here in the dealer table also. In dealer table, decode is the primary key. See, you can say decode is the primary key. Every dealer will get separate code. This is D name. D name can be repeated. Dealer can have multiple dealers can have same name. It can keep be repeated. So decode is the primary key of this dealer table. The same thing here in the stock table. So in stock table, decode is known as the foreign key. In stock table, decode is known as the foreign key and item number is the primary key. Where in dealer table, decode is known as the primary key. So can you identify which is the child table and which is the parent table? Yes. This is dealer is the parent table. And you find out the foreign key here in the stock table. So stock is the child table. So which one you have to create first? First you have to create the parent table. Which is the parent table here? Dealer is the parent table. So the first step you have to create the dealer table. After that you have to create the stock table. Now, I will set the foreign key. I will show the syntax how to set the foreign key. Yes, go through the SQL screen. Yes, I am going to create the table. First, the second example I can do it here. First, I am going to create the dealer table. So, dealer is the parent table. Stock is the child table. So, I am going to create the dealer table. Create table dealer. Create table dealer and decode. See, decode, what is the data type? Character. So you can say character of 3 and dname character of 10. Yes. Now I have to set decode as the primary key. See, how can you set decode as the primary key? That you studied last class. So you are creating a table. So after declaring the data type, you can use the keyword primary key. Okay, now press the enter key. What is the mistake here? What is the error in this query? You can see the error, spelling mistake is here, data. Okay, now press the enter key. Yes, the table is created. I'll show you the query once again. Just go through the query once again. So now the dealer table is created. You created the dealer table. Next step, you have to insert the value into the dealer table. So I am going to insert the value into the dealer table. Insert into dealer. Insert into dealer. Insert into dealer. Yes. See the first one, decode. I am going to give the decode as D101. D101, it's a character value. It must be enclosed in single quote. Comma. Next is D name. I am going to give the D name as George. Yes. I didn't use the keyword values. So values. Values close. Again error. See what is the error here? I just mentioned D name. What is the error? Can you say what is the error here? Data too long for column decode. I just given decode as character of 3. And I've given 4 values here. That is why it's showing the error message. So you just want to remove it. Just press the enter key. One record is inserted. Understood? I'm going to insert one more record. It is as 02. And I'm going to change the name as Matthew. Yes, it is Matthew. Two records are inserted. So now you created the parent table. In parent table, primary key is decode. Next, I am going to create the child table. So, create table stock. Create table stock. I'll show you the child table once again. Just go through that one. This is the child table. Okay. Create table. Item number. Item number. Int. Item name. Character. Of 10, then decode int, character of 3, because already here in the parent table decode is character. So normally in child table, so same code, same thing coming over here. So normally decode is will be character itself. So once again, whatever the value we are giving inside the parent table of the primary key. Whatever the value you are giving the primary key of the parent table, The same value will be accepted here in the foreign key. It will not accept any other value other than which is present in the primary key column of the parent table. Is it understood? The value which you entered in the parent table, primary key of the parent table, the same value must be accepted here in the foreign key of the child table. No other value will be accepted here in the foreign key. I'll show you that one. Now, I am not entering more attribute there. I am just entering only three attributes. Item number. I am going to set item number as the primary key. So, it is primary key. Yes, item number set as the primary key. Item name, character, decode, character of three. See, only three attributes I am going to specify here. Now, I want to set decode as the foreign key. So, after declaring all the attributes, so I'll declare one more attribute, QTY, that is integer. Now, just put the comma. After declaring all the attributes, use the keyword foreign key. Foreign key is two different words. See the spelling. Foreign space key. Then, inside the bracket, you have to say, which will be set as the foreign key. We have to set decode as the foreign key. So, you just specify that attribute inside the bracket. Foreign key, inside the bracket, specify the attribute. Then, use the keyword references. References, that is a keyword, references. And this table referring which table? Stock table is referring which table? That is referring dealer table. Yes, in dealer table. In dealer table, which attribute it is referring? It is decode. Check it, you understood or not? Go through the query once again. First, you have to declare all the attribute. Comma. Then you have to use the keyword foreign key. Inside the bracket, you have to mention the attribute which you want to set as the foreign key. Yes, that is mentioned. After that, you have to use the keyword references. References. And which table it is referring? It is referring the table dealer. So, references dealer. In dealer table, which attribute it is referring? That is inside the bracket decode. Now, press the enter key. You can see the table is created. Okay. Query is okay means there is no syntax error. The table is created. Just describe and see the table stock. Describe stock. You can see item number is primary key and see this decode is MUL. That means it's a foreign key. That means it's a foreign key. That decode is set as the foreign key. Now I am going to insert the value into the stock table. After setting the constraint, you just describe the table and after that insert the value. Now I am going to insert into stock. Insert into stock. Values. Insert into stock values. The first one is item number. I am going to give the item number as 100, comma. Next one is item. So I am going to give the item name as pencil, comma. Next one is decode. I told you decode must be the value which is present in the parent table. Understood? Whatever the value, whatever the decode, whatever the foreign key value you are giving in the child table, the same thing must be present in the primary key column of the parent table. I am going to give D01 is a character value enclosed in single quote. D01, and the next one is quantity. Just press the enter key. Check it is accepting or not. Yes. I am going to press the enter key. Yes, it is accepted. And I am going to insert the next value. Next value, stock. See, it is an item name. And here, I am going to give D02. Yes, it's okay. Accepted. Now, just I am going to give 103. Then, it's item name and here I am going to give D03. Just press the enter key. See, it is showing the error message. Why it is showing the error message? because D03 is the foreign key which is not present in the parent table. In D03 is not present in the parent table. Just see, I'll show you that star, select star from dealer. It is the parent table. Just press the enter key. Only D01 and D02 is there. So if you're trying to run this query, it will show the error message because D03 is not present in the parent table. Now I am going to change this dealer code as D02. D02. Just press the enter key. Yes, it is accepting. I'll show you the content. Select star from stock. Select star from stock. Just see the content of the table. You can see the content of the table. Now you understood two different things. What are they? What are they? The values which are accepting under the foreign key column must be present in the parent table, must be present in the primary key of the parent table. Right? And one more thing. Can you say what is the second thing? Yes, foreign key can be repeated. Foreign key can be repeated. You can see, decode is a foreign key and this foreign key is repeating here. D02 is repeating here. Primary key cannot be repeated. That is the actual definition of the primary key. But what can be repeated? Foreign key can be repeated. Understood all of you? So that is all about foreign key. So foreign key, actually the foreign key will relate or link two different tables. It will link two different tables. Syntax is given here and identify the parent table. This is the parent table and this is the child table. First, you have to create the parent table. That is why I just written the parent table create query first. And here also the parent table is this one and child table is this one. Okay? Understood all of you? That is all about foreign key. Now, this is just a small description about this one is written over there. A table can have only one primary key, but any number of foreign key can be accepted. A table can have multiple foreign key. Now, primary key value cannot be repeated, but foreign key value can be repeated. But foreign key value must be present in the primary key of the parent table. Okay? This much? Understood, I think so. All of you understood now? So next thing, next topic, we can study in the next class. Thank you, children.